Real-time quantitative PCR allows you to measure the amplification of PCR products in real time. Among many other applications, this can help you measure the gene expression levels in a sample. The first thing you need to do is decide if you're going to use probe or dye-based qPCR. Probe-based qPCR requires a sequence-specific probe that is labeled with a fluorescent reporter. This is great for multiplexing if you want to detect multiple sequences in the same reaction. Dye-based qPCR uses fluorescent dyes that bind double-stranded DNA to measure the accumulation of PCR product. This eliminates the need for specially labeled primers or probes, but it's less specific than probe-based. Let's say you've decided to use dye-based qPCR. To set up your reaction, find your DNA template, your qPCR primers, nuclease-free water, a dye-based qPCR master mix, and all the appropriate controls based on your experimental design. Begin by preparing the appropriate dilutions of your DNA in nuclease-free water. Add an appropriate volume of diluted DNA or nuclease-free water for negative control to all of the appropriate wells of your reaction plate. This volume will vary based on your planned total reaction volume and the size of plate you're using, but in general, you'll want the sample volume to be under 20% of the total reaction volume. Prepare your reaction mix in a separate tube by adding the master mix, nuclease-free water, forward and reverse primers, and any additional magnesium chloride that you may need. Depending on which instrument you're using, you might also need CXR reference dye. The exact volumes of all of these will vary based on the concentrations of all your reagents, but make sure they add up to your planned total reaction volume. Gently vortex the tube to make sure it's fully mixed. Make sure it doesn't foam. Carefully add reaction mix to each well. Seal the plate and centrifuge it at a low speed for about 1 minute to make sure all the reagents and sample go to the bottom of the wells. If liquid stays on the side of the well, it could mess up your results. You're almost ready! On your real-time PCR instrument, select the detection and reference dyes for the plate, find the proper cycling program, and designate the data that will be collected during the annealing step. If you're unsure of any of these settings, consider checking out the instrument manual. Now, you can place your plate in the thermal cycler and press Start. This video is brought to you by GoTac qPCR Systems, a convenient mix of optimized components for dye-based qPCR.